15 months.
Labour and then quick diverted, and that was a hospital up there. Elizabeth Creek comes in. That was a little house up there we photographed earlier. And bridge has got $1.25 million red bricks in it, and they're all excavated McQuaid from over the other side here. Hasn't had any restoration since it was built, no modifications. It's designed just to carry horses and carts. The first local went over with his kid on his shoulders after the opening. All convict made bricks at sixpence a day, the convicts were paid. And some of them are underfired and some of them are overfired. And you get dark crosses made up of the dark and light coloured bricks. If we can pick them anywhere. Takes 1 million vehicles a year now. So many trailers and cars on Highway 1 to Hobart and Launceston.
Brewery, when they built the two-story building, and that's the top floor, and the bottom floor is now underground. They had, when they built up the approaches to the bridge so that cars could go, so that carts could go across it, they drowned the bottom story, so you can just see the top of the window in one section. And it used to be a two-story brewery. Yeah.
Traffic. Just behind here in Ross, there's Ross Bridge.
When the bullets come past.
Oh, okay, this is for the when the traffic comes past. That's a great idea. Lucky there are no semi-trailers. work out the sun. It's coming and going. We're going to run out of battery again. The overseer's cottage. It's the original cemetery. Should be interesting. This is the main street at 6 o'clock or so in Ross. And caravan park's down the right, so we just wander around. See the water moving.
Barely.
Lovely campsite at Ross. We're all packed ready to go. And here's some of the historic wall all around the campground. That's some of the more attractive vistas from the campground. And that's the two-star toilet block. It's a disabled with a leaking shower rose. That's the motel attached to the new area. Just parked under the tree, and all the tourists have arrived now, and the shops are being opened, and there's little buses around, and the bakery, looks like she runs the bakery, is opening. That's unique chainsaws. And just looking across the bonnet and the car here, anywhere you park there's a photo opportunity. And he's just checking out the location of the second hand shop. Looks like you can pay for a ride around town. There's the usual two Telstra telephone booths that are a bit more in keeping. They camp just down near the fluid waste spot, but also just not far from the love seat and the bridge. And we walked around last night around the heritage walk and heard a train go by up near the cemetery. This is the back of the wood-fired bakery. It's still going after 100 years. And it actually wasn't the back of the bakery, it was a looks like an old RSL type place. It's actually 11:30. Well, last night we walked up here and there was not a car or a soul in the street. We had it to ourselves. One or two people maybe. All the tourists come here after December. For $5 you can walk around this little garden here. This is actually the garden that you pay your money to see. Wait for the camper van to drive off. Maybe. Just our luck. I don't think they're hungry for tourists in some of those little places. They've probably gone fishing. Our horse, where are you? Oh, okay. I can just see the red telephone box, so I'll come down. Bye. Bye. Cars and Swiss tourists keep going up and down the street. You watch. Oh, she just ducked underneath the camera. I still haven't found my treasure. I suppose they're good at standing still all day, waiting for a tourist to take them for a walk. He's waiting for the next run. Some of you may not know what that is. Or that. We were actually here last night when they cleared the mail. You don't?
Didn't the official credential fall?
Oh, okay. You don't have a cap. They used to wear a little cap. We were camped up at Stumpy Bay. Well, as with a lot of these maps and things they give away, the caravan park didn't pay their money, so they're not on the map. Maybe the sewage disposal place in the love chair paid their money. I still haven't found Mary yet. She needs a map. The four corners, Ross, the four corners, that is the old jail. The Catholic Church. And you stand in the middle of the road in this place. I think I found Mary up there. She just phoned me. This is a fairly old establishment here. Admire
it. I just think it's lovely.
Where we spent a fortune. Another fortune.
Just missed your foot.
Oh, good.
Just take.
He finally gets to go for a ride. We'll head off now and find a spot for lunch. The local farmer's come in and he's got his sheep and his dog in with the sheep. And we decide to have lunch just here under the trees. Well, we've moved on now, climbed up to 880 odd meters past a group of hang gliders. One lake, Lake Sorrel and Lake Crescent, they're connected.
Yeah, Sorrel's behind you.
They're connected by a canal. Just back there, there's a first gear hill climb all the way up, and one huge logging truck fully laden met us on a corner on a steep patch. He hadn't been chatting on his radio when we met him. Oh, it's a Ramsar bird sanctuary. And it's another place of shacks. And very old caravan sites. I believe they go fishing up here somewhere. That's the old Interlaken Lodge. People used to stay here and shoot wallabies and ducks and fish. It's all private property all through around there. Couple of horses watching us. A few shacks left on the northern lake. And the southern lake abuts this beautiful sandfly flats. I suggested we walk down there, but probably run into a few black snakes. And we're just heading off up to the steppes. Find another little spot to camp. This must be a collector's edition of the Telstra phone, right up in no man's land.